What's up? Welcome back to Hummingbird YouTube channel. We're really excited to be coming at you with another video in our top 20 songs of 2020 series. Once again today, we're partnering with Two Brains, another music channel. So after you watch our video today, make sure you head over there to check out theirs.
Also very exciting about this one is that it's Rubik's Cube edition. If you notice when in this video I've completed the Rubik's Cube, maybe I've done it a couple times, maybe this has just been one solve, but make sure to drop that in the comments. You'll win a prize, which is love and affection from me. Let's get into it.
Alright, for my number 10, I have Like My Daddy by D-Smoke coming off of the Black Habits album. Big shout out to D-Smoke. I think this dude is great. I think despite, you know, winning Rhythm and Flow as well as getting the Grammy nomination on his album, I think people are still sleeping. I think people might think he's a little bit washed up or too industry or anything like that, but I think as soon as you check out Black Habits, you realize that he's just an elite rapper and that's really it. I really like the song Like My Daddy. It's got some really strong verses in there and a really catchy chorus, and I think what does it for me most is the production on that song, really sick beat from this producer named Wobeast. Not really familiar with you, but Wobeast, if you're watching this, that bass line is crazy.
The common experience of the masses is having to work for. Everything that you get, you purchase with hurt feelings. Even when you hit ceilings, you deserve more.
You talking about the way he came up is pretty poignant because I think a lot of people are sleeping on him because of the way he came up. I don't know if there's a lot of authenticity in Rhythm and Flow. People aren't seeing that yet, but I think he's proving that, like, these kind of, it's kind of a gimmick to have a show like that, but D-Smoke is no gimmick.
I'm super fly, step me down, there's plenty you and I. Tired of hitting stores and seeing shit that I can't buy. Gotta get rich up in this bitch on my nephew, Makai.
At number 10, I got Shots Fired by Megan Thee Stallion. This song is the first one off her album, Good News. It's pretty much a diss track against that bastard Tory Lanez. You know me, I've been calling him the Kyle Kuzma of the rap game recently. And as Shannon Sharp just said, he would trade Kuzma for a 12-pack of Clorox wipes. So I'd probably say the same thing about Tory Lanez. But back to the point of the song, which is that it's really hard. It has that Who Shot Ya sample on there, and Megan comes in just so hard. It's probably the best diss track of the year.
Imagine niggas lying by shooting a real bitch. Just a save face for rapper niggas you chill with. Imagine me giving a fuck, it was your fucking birthday. You and your feelings, I just thought it was another Thursday.
Definitely left Tory Lanez in bits and pieces. So I enjoyed seeing that.
Yeah, great use of the sample on that song.
Yeah, extremely.
If it wasn't for me, same week you'd have been indicted. You walk the M's, not the talk, I guess that made my friend excited. Now y'all in cahoots, you a puss in boots. You shot a 5'10", bitch, with a 22.
At my number 9, I got Entrepreneur by Pharrell Williams featuring Jay-Z. Yeah. I know that sounds like a hot take. I know this song didn't get a lot of love around there, but you know, for me, I just really liked this track. Anything where Pharrell and Jay-Z are coming together, I think I'm going to appreciate, especially with the type of, you know, message and energy that they came at with this track. I think some people didn't like it from Pharrell's like type vibe, and maybe people thought Jay-Z's bars were a little to new age Jay-Z or whatever, but honestly, I think those people just need to, you know, appreciate a Jay-Z and Pharrell track.
For everyone, Gucci support two fubus, sipping Crippa Cola, consumer and a owner, till we all vertically integrated from the flow up.
The other thing that really does it for me with the song is the video that comes along with it, just like the way that they're able to, you know, shout out like Black success and really empower all those different people who are doing amazing things by giving them short snippets, and that video was really special.
You want to be let out of here, you're welcome to go.
It's the type of song that can show my mom, I can post a video on Facebook, gives me that kind of feels.
Yeah, definitely, it's a really good track. I think also part of like the dislike people are getting from it is that it's not made to be like a hit single or anything. They're like focusing on empowerment, not making bangers.
Black man. Black man, 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 black man
My number 9 is the reason I'm wearing this shirt right now. Shout out to Dayon Greene. It's his song Free, which was a single off of his debut album Me that came out this past summer. Free was produced by a good friend, my man Caps Lock. Great beat on there. And Dayon comes through with some really fantastic bars, just about freedom, expressing some subjectivity, just feeling good about himself and I guess just existing in a positive way.
Yeah, and I think that Dayon Greene project just shows everything that he really wants to accomplish and things that he's working towards, and it's a great showcase of what he's already capable of at this point.
Not just talking, I'm trying to be freer than a slave in June on the 19th day, but y'all like the fucking black plague. Give me space, please stay away.
For my number 8, I got Nike Shoebox by Lou Phelps. I'm gonna start off by saying it. Lou Phelps' Extra Extra is the most underrated album of this year, I think. You know, Lou, brother of my favorite artist of all time, Catronata, these two work so well together, and this project really shows what they're going to do as siblings for the rest of their life, probably. You know, I've been following these two since they dropped their collab tape together in 2014, and so just to see them come together one more time for this project was really nice. You know, it's a 7-song project, 5 of which are produced by Catronata, 1 is produced by Lock-In, and 1 is produced by Teclan. Those dudes are all, you know, really hotshot producers that I've been following for a long time, so I just really appreciated Lou going out there and getting some really interesting and very dope beats for this project. But on Nike Shoebox, really sick video that comes with it. I just thought Lou's bars are really good. The chorus is super catchy. And of course, you know, that Catron beat is one that I think all rappers would want to hop on.
Definitely.
I see this seat is all mine, I haven't claimed it though. I hope you haters all shine, I let they shade it show. I'm used to seeing they sleep, but now they peeping though. Oh yeah, they peeping ho.
My number 8 is Minding My Business by Knxwledge, featuring Durand, Bernarr, and Rose Gold. It's a really beautiful song. As we all saw this summer, it can be really difficult to pretty much quarantine in a living situation with the same people for months on end, and when that happens, the smallest things can kind of start bothering you, and this song, Minding My Business, really helped me, I guess, change my mindset with that. It's just a song about minding your business, sticking to what you can control, and that really resonated with me. It's a beautiful song with some soaring vocals from Durand, Bernarr, and Rose Gold.
I just wanna mind my business, and tend to this business, minding my business.
For my number 7, I got Wildfires by Sault. Big shout out to Sault. I think this crew is awesome. There are 3 people in the band, but other than that, there's really no information to be found about them. There's no names, there's no faces. They don't tell you when they're releasing music, they just do it, which is something that I really like and have enjoyed so far this year with their 2 projects that they dropped. The one that this Wildfire song comes off is the Untitled Blackest project, which dropped on Juneteenth. And I think since then, this album has easily been in my top few, and I've always enjoyed going back and listening to it. But I think with Wildfires, it's a really special track. It just, you got some really nice and resounding vocals on there, and just like a really nice and stable beat throughout the whole track.
But we will never show fear.
The albums that they've put out this year, they're really cohesive and flow really well as entire albums, but Wildfires sticks out as one of them that could just be a standalone single and find a lot of success.
Yeah, definitely.
My number 7 is Cut Me by Moses Sumney. I think that it was a really wonderful track off of his album Grey, a double album, that came out with each side coming out a couple months from each other. On an album that talked a lot about liminality and identity being split up in a lot of ways and having a hard time fitting in. Cut Me, if I'm, I guess, seeing it correctly, Cut Me seems like, I guess, cutting identity maybe. And I thought that was an interesting way to express the way he feels about that. Really beautiful song compositionally. It shows him as a producer doing really well. But I guess the cherry on top of the cake are his vocals. They're just soaring and so clear. It's like impossible not to, I guess, hear his emotion that he's trying to put out with it.
Yeah, definitely. I think he has a really unique ability of being like really expressive with his music.
That's when I feel, yeah, the most alive.
At my number 6, I got Yamame by Nathy Peluso. Big shout out to Michael for already giving some props to Nathy Peluso and that Calambre project with that Buenos Aires pick on his last video. But for me, Yamame was really the song that came off this project that showed me what she is really capable of. Just a very soothing, very chill song, and I just think the tempo is there. Mm-hmm. It's a song that you can pretty much play in many situations. It just plays very well. This song really shows that diversity of talents that we were talking about with the last track as well. I mean, if you listen to this song and then listen to Sana Sana and then listen to Buenos Aires, you're gonna hear such a different sound coming from Nathy Peluso, and I think that it just shows the talent so well for her.
At number 6, I have Friends by Teyana Taylor, representing my favorite album of the year, the album. I thought Friends was a really wonderful song because it talks about, I guess, intimacy and relationships, but also being vulnerable enough to understand that that relationship might not be what you want. She says some lyrics about, if it ain't what you want.
If it ain't me that you want, boy, that's cool. If you wanna leave right now, you ain't gotta be locked down, go do you.
And I guess just setting boundaries in a really effective way, I think it's something we can all learn from, just being honest with people. This beat is also really good. It's knocking, it's bumping all over the place, and she really shows her ability to rap on this song.
If I ain't the one, I'm the two. Don't you go leaving me no room to assume. Tell me now, is you ducking in and out of love? Is you, that ain't really good for my trust.
All right, so now we get to react to Two Brains lists. For their 10 to 6, Liv had Franchise by Travis Scott featuring Young Thug and MIA. At number 9, Walking in the Snow by Run the Jewels. At number 8, she has RNS by 21 Savage and Metro Boomin featuring Young Thug. Number 7 is So Heavy I Fell Through the Earth by Grimes. And number 6 is Wash Us in the Blood by Kanye featuring Travis Scott. I thought this was a pretty cool list. I honestly, Travis Scott is an artist that I've liked a lot in the past, and it was cool to be able to, I guess, spotlight these because they kind of fell through the cracks for me this year, I guess.
Yeah, definitely. I think that's fair. I think definitely a lot of big name artists on here that are exciting to see.
Yeah.
I think, you know, that Kanye song is really good, and I'm happy to see that on the list. RNS, definitely one of the biggest tracks to come off of that Metro Boomin 21 Savage project, and I think deservedly so. There's a lot of baller energy on that track, and you just get some really dope flows from 21 Savage.
Absolutely, and it was cool to see the Run the Jewels shout out. That's an album I really loved when it came out. I haven't listened to it as much recently, but again, this was a good reminder of how strong of a project that was. That's definitely top 10, top 15. Albums this year for me.
This Grimes track is a good pick. I like seeing it on there. I think she's had a very interesting year in the spotlight, just being, you know, in the news and naming her children and things of this sort. But, you know, yeah. I think this song shows off her ability as an artist really well. It's very poetic, very vocal reliant, and I think it's just altogether an impressive track.
Definitely. Don't keep shorting Tesla.
All right, from the Marlins 10 to 6, we start off at 10 with Microdosing by 070 Shake. Then Blue World at 9 by Mac Miller.
I like that one.
Algorithm by Childish Gambino next. Normal People by Joji feat. Ray Brown. And then lastly at number 6, we got All I Need feat. Mahalia and Ty Dolla $ign by Jacob Collier. Mm. This is a very interesting list, actually. I really like it. I think it's all kind of fringe hip-hop type music. Like, not like right in the center of what hip-hop or rap is, but like definitely a lot of the type of music that is like coming off around that. Like, I think Blue World by Mac Miller is obviously a very dope track to have on there.
It's wonderful.
Microdosing is a super sick song. So yeah, altogether I think this list is really interesting for the ways it kind of interweaves like with rap music and with each other.
Definitely. I thought also that All I Need song is how I found Jacob Collier. That was a really cool performance on like Jimmy Fallon or something like that, where they were playing the song in the bathroom and Ty Dolla $ign was like smoking a blunt inside the mirror or something like that. I thought that was a cool way to do the video. Overall, a really great track. Algorithm by Childish Gambino. Not necessarily the song I would have chosen from that album, probably 1238 with that 21 Savage verse, but I thought that was really cool. You know, that whole Gambino album was just very out there.
Yeah, and I appreciate seeing, you know, a track from that list making it on both Liv and Marlon's lists, and I think, you know, just shout out to Childish Gambino for still making music and making the kind of music that he's passionate about, you know.
Absolutely.
All right, yeah, so those were our 10 to 6 tracks, and that was also us reacting to Marlon and Liv's 10 to 6. If you liked our songs, let us know in the comments. If you like Living Marlin songs, make sure to go over to Two Brains and let them know too. Check out in our bio, we got links to our Spotify and Apple Music playlists. We're updating those every week to match the songs that we talk about, so make sure you go check out those links for our 10 to 5 tracks. Stay tuned next Sunday for our 5 to 1 final picks.
Yeah, those are going to be really exciting. Obviously, our favorite tracks of the year. I think there are some definite all-stars MVPs of the year, so looking forward to that one.